not mere walking, it is not using our feet. But this walking is in our heart. Pastor, you are welcome.
Pastor, turakwakire kugira ngo tubwire.
We thank God for the lesson.
Turashimira Imana ku bwayimigisho.
The thrust of this week's lesson.
Icyigisho imigisho yose cy'umwaka ko kirangiye.
It is clear to us all.
Ni ukuri birasobanutse neza.
Walk in the Spirit.
Kugendera mu mwuka.
What is to walk in the Spirit? I think it has been explained. It's not about walking physically. But it is about the living. The life we live being led by the Spirit. It is the life we live overcoming. Overcoming the desires of our own flesh. When we choose, because as an individual you have to choose. Christianity is about choosing. Because options are there. Are we together? Options are there. You can choose not to come to church. You can choose not to keep the Sabbath. You can choose to fornicate. You can choose to steal. You can choose to lie. And the good part of the other choices. Let me give you advantages of the other choices. If you want to lie, you can say anything. If you want to lie, you can say anything. You can do anything. Why? Because lying is not truth. The difficult part with truth, it is the only thing. The difficult part with the truth. The truth is only one. We don't have five truths. We don't have two truths. We have one truth. So if you are to walk in the truth, you are supposed to pick one thing. But if you want to choose lying, you can say anything. You can do anything. You can go anywhere. You can eat anything. You can be anybody. You can dress anyhow. Because you are living in a lie. But those who live in the truth, are we seeing the difference? Those who live in the truth, who are led by the Spirit, those who walk in the Spirit, they have a single way. They don't walk differently. They don't walk differently. But they walk straight. Why? Because the truth is one. We don't have different ways. Hence the question. Then comes the question to you. As we close this lesson, shall you walk by the truth? Shall you walk by the Spirit? Shall you walk after the Spirit? Shall you walk in the Spirit? Or you shall walk anyhow? Because if you walk in the Spirit, you have an identity. You have a name. You have a destination. You have an end that is sure. That is definite. That is defined. That is known. But if you walk in any other way, if you walk in any other things, if you choose not to walk in the Spirit, You don't have an identity. So my question is, do you want an identity? I want to walk in the Spirit. Why? Because in the Spirit, there is the victory of Jesus. In the Spirit, we are given a victory. Yes, we have a battle inside our hearts. As it is given in the lesson, there is a battle of each and every day choosing between right and wrong. Choosing between right and wrong. Choosing between right and wrong. But there is victory in Jesus. Why? When we choose to walk in the Spirit, we are going to overcome this decision making. In the leading, as the what's that language? Chinyarwanda says. You are to be led by the Spirit. We are to be led by the Spirit. We have victory in Jesus. When we are led by the Spirit. I choose to walk with Jesus. I choose to walk in the Spirit. Is there somebody who chooses also to walk in the Spirit? Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we are raising our hands. Because we choose to walk with you. We are choosing to walk with you. We are choosing to be led by your Spirit. We are choosing to live according to your Spirit. Come down and talk to us. Come down and lead us. We want to listen to you. When you speak, we want to listen. We want to hear you. We want you. We are not able to choose if you are not there. Father, therefore, will take us away. But if you are close to us, we have this confidence. We have this joy.